everyone. So today I'm gonna do a no makeup, makeup, natural makeup look. I'm on that time of the month, you know what I'm saying? Broke out and then I've got fake tan on my face and it's just like clung to every patch of dry skin or like acne on my face. So I've got all these like random dark orangey red spots on my face now. But hey, that's what this makeup look is for. This makeup look is perfect for when you want to look super presentable and you want to look like done up, but you don't want to look like you're wearing a ton of makeup. Some days I love a dramatic look, some days I love a good smoky eye, other days I just want to look really fresh-faced and natural, so here we go. By the way, this is going to be a little bit different to some of my past no makeup makeup looks because I'm actually going to make my skin look quite flawless. In other ones, I'm kind of just like, oh, like real natural, natural, whatever. I'll link them down below. This one, I'm going to do a little bit more work. So this is going to be one of those no makeup makeup tutorials which involves like a million products. Just warning you now. So first I'm just going to chuck my hair out of my face. Sassy. The first thing I'm going to do is take a dewy finishing spray and I'm going to spritz that on my face before I start. This one is by NYX. If you think about it, natural skin has a natural kind of satin, slightly glowy finish. So we don't want a full-on matte look because that looks a lot more makeup like. Now I'm going to take a neutralizing primer and this one here is by Bare Minerals. It's the Prime Time neutralizing one. It's one of my favorites. My skin is not liking me at the moment. Hormones, aren't they great? Next I'm going to take my base makeup and I'm just going to use this Bare Minerals Complexion Rescue, and yes, it's got tape on it because my dogs chewed the edge off and I didn't want to waste it and I didn't want to depot it. So I taped it up. Kiwi Ingenuity, guys. So I'm just taking some of this and popping that on my face. I am going to use a brush to blend it in just because I don't really like using my fingers. Sorry if you can hear weird noises. I've got the window open today because it's really hot in my room. And I can't cope. And a fan is noisy. So hopefully no one outside is noisy. Sorry if the lighting keeps changing. The sky is having a meltdown. For my concealer today, I'm using two different kinds. I'm using my usual Pro Conceal around my eye area to conceal the bags and redness on my eyelids. And then on the rest of my face, I'm going to use this Charlotte Tilbury The Retoucher Conceal and Treat Stick. And it's just one of those like highlighting pens. These are made from so many different brands, so feel free to use whichever one you prefer. And I'm just going to use this around my mouth and anywhere I want to kind of highlight and conceal. And you don't have to worry about this too much because it's such a lightweight product that it'll just blend out beautifully. So I'm just popping some around my face and then I'm also going to do my concealer. Concealer I'm just putting around my eyes and I like to do it in a triangle shape up to my cheekbones as well. It's actually like turning into nighttime outside. I don't know what's happening. It's creepy. It's like getting really dark as if it's like 5 o'clock at night. So you can see now that my skin has pretty good coverage. I've still got a few like blemishes and some redness showing through, but I'm gonna leave it like that because for a no makeup makeup look, like a natural makeup look, that's totally fine by me. Like this is still pretty flawless, I would say. And I don't want to look completely overdone and then have like no makeup on the rest of my face. So the next step, cream bronzing, and tons of different brands do cream bronzers now. I'm gonna use this one by Chanel just because it's like one of my favorites. I don't know. The reason I go for cream bronzers for a natural look is it sinks into your skin and it looks so much more natural than like a powder bronzer. Powder bronzers are much more obvious. I am still gonna use a little bit of a powder bronzer later, but yeah, for the most of the bronzing, I'm gonna use this. There goes a plane. For this step, I'm gonna use a round top face brush by Exo Beauty. This one's like freshly washed. Yes. And then my Bronze Universal. And I'm just gonna take a little bit and kind of pop that on the sides of my face where I would naturally get bronzed. And I'm not trying to contour with this, but I am gonna put it just under my cheekbones a little bit to warm up the cheeks. And then around the sides of my temples where I would naturally hit the sun, a little bit up on my forehead. And then a little bit on my nose because you know it sticks out, you know, it's gonna hit that sun. And then before I powder anything, I'm just going to let that set into my skin so that it looks as natural as possible. So I'm just going to work on the rest of my face, like my eyes. I should should say, just my eyes. So now that I've got my glow done, I'm gonna move on to my eyebrows. And usually I would use like eyebrow pencil, brow mascara, all of that kind of thing. I'm still gonna use those products, but I'm gonna use a lot less of them and really focus on the areas I need it rather than just filling in like the entire brow. I'm just going to work on the areas where my eyebrows are sparse. Just like on the top, see how like my eyebrow, like this one's filled in a bit, and this one, like it's a little bit lower because my hairs up here grow downwards, so the root of my hairs is like really fair. So I just like to fill in the very tops, and then of course just in here a tiny bit, my favorite brow plumper, L'Oreal, and just wipe off the excess off the tip and then run a little bit of that through. And the reason I love this in general is because it's so natural. It just gives you a really thick, natural appearing brow. So I'm gonna put some of that through my whole brow. Next up for the eyes, I am gonna take a eyeshadow color that is very similar to my skin tone and put that all over. The shade is Anastasia Soft Peach, and this is a round top blending brush by EXO Beauty, and I'm just going to buff that on. And then to highlight your brow bone, you want to take something quite natural. This one is Vanilla Bean by Makeup Geek. This is an angled eyeshadow brush by EXO Beauty, and I'm just going to put a little bit of that just underneath the brow. And you just want to make sure that you blend it out really, really well so it looks quite seamless. And then also take the tiniest bit right on your tear duct. You don't want to drag it up or down or inwards too far. You want to put it right on it. And then the last step I'm going to do is take another blending brush. And this time you want to go into a colour that's a shade or two darker than your skin tone. I'm using Creme Brulee by Makeup Geek. And this is a tapered crease brush by EXO Beauty. And just buff that in really, really well. And you only want to put that in the socket because that's where you naturally have dimension. And this is just going to add a little bit of structure to your eye shape. And then just go in with that first blending brush and blend over there and make sure it's really seamless because you want it to look almost not there. I'm also going to take a tiny bit underneath my lash line, like really close to my lash line, just to add a little bit of a natural shadow. I'm taking that highlight colour on my finger and just popping a little bit of that on my eyelid, just blending that out thoroughly. And this is just going to brighten up my eye area but still keep it looking quite natural. So that is the eyeshadow, and now of course we want to do some mascara and everything, but first I'm going to set my face. The foundation and everything has definitely like had time to settle into my skin now, and the reason I want to set everything down before I do my mascara, if you guys ever have the problem of your mascara like transferring onto your like bone or like under eye area or like brow bone or anything, it's usually because the area is quite moist or wet or oily. So if you get oily skin or if you don't set your foundation, etc., etc., when it's powdered it doesn't transfer very easily, so I just want to make sure that I powder everything so my mascara doesn't smudge and smear all over the place. I'm just going to use this NYX contour kit and mix these two together, and this is going under my eye area and just kind of highlighting my face a little bit. And then on the rest of my face, I'm going to use a translucent powder. This is the NYX HD one. I am so gutted. I feel like I wasn't filming for like the last few minutes. My camera just like stops filming sometimes. It's so frustrating. And update, is pissing down with rain outside. So if you can hear it, I'm really sorry, but I can't do anything. And I'm already so far through this video that I've like committed, so. So what I did was I went in to the NYX palette and took the contour shade, tapped the excess onto my hand, and literally had like the smallest amount of bronzer on the brush as possible, and then just put that right into my cheekbones. The smallest amount. Powders are always going to look more obvious than a cream. And then I forgot to do my cream blush before. Cream blush, again, it's going to look more natural because it'll sink into your skin and just like do its thing. I forgot, obviously, as I just set my foundation and everything. I used a really small amount of Dolly Mix. Believe it or not, this color actually looks really natural on me with a light hand. Just find whatever blush looks natural on you. It might be more peachy, it might be more pink. Just kind of play around with it. You'll find something that suits you. For highlight, I would usually skip it, but I showed you this one. If you really, really do want to highlight, this is MAC Emphasize, and it's just a really natural kind of sheer slightly satiny, glowy powder, so it's not shimmery or glittery, so you're not gonna look like a disco ball. It's just a really natural kind of glow. Holy crap, you guys, this weather is trying to sabotage my filming. Seriously, I just used a brown mascara because brown is always gonna look a little bit more natural than black. It's a little bit softer. You can totally go for black, it's up to you. I used NYX color mascara in brown, so that's what is on my lashes now that I'm filming for sure. I'm using the NYX Wonder Pencil, and I'm just gonna put a little bit of this on my waterline just to brighten up my eyes. And then, totally optional step, if you do want a little bit more glam in your natural no makeup look, you can totally add some lashes if you've got quite like sparse natural lashes, or if you want some more volume or whatever. So I'm going to use EXO Beauty the Flower Child. These are very natural half lashes. Can everyone like just be quiet? I'm trying to film. So here's how they look, and you can see they've got an invisible lash band, which is important because I'm not wearing eyeliner. You can see the difference that makes. It just adds more volume and really lifts your eye and makes it look a little bit more glam. But it's still so natural and easy to wear for an everyday look. First off, I'm just going to wipe off the foundation that has collected upon my mouth. That sounded so gross. I've got the hiccups. Everything is going wrong. Okay, I'm just gonna go for it because this is the Rimmel Lasting Finish lip liner in 49 natural. Oh my god, I can't deal. 49 natural. Just take something that's similar to your natural lip color and just line your lips. I'm so scared I'm gonna hiccup while I'm doing this because then I'm just gonna be like, what? Sole purpose of this is just to define my lips because my natural lip line is quite, like, not defined, if you know what I mean. Oh, that was a loud one. So you can see the difference. This side is lined and this side isn't. It's just a little bit more, it's got more oomph, you know? Oh gosh. I'm using a little bit of Too Faced Lip Injection and just putting on a really sheer layer just so that your lips look nice and hydrated, like you've got some lip balm on or something, except it's gonna plump your lips, so double whammy. Oh my gosh. You can still tell I'm wearing makeup, but it is very natural, and as I said at the beginning of the video, it's a little bit more made up than my past no makeup looks. I cannot deal. And this has been really highly requested to do a really flawless no makeup makeup look, so this is what I would call like a flawless no makeup makeup look. So let's just have a little bit of a comparison side by side, makeup on, makeup off. I know half of you are gonna be like, oh my gosh, like why would you go to that much effort to do a no makeup makeup look? I don't know. Some people do though, like some people like this look. And as I said, this is the kind of makeup look I like to rock a lot as well. It just makes me feel really like put together, and it makes me feel very confident without feeling like, sometimes I just feel like when I do heavy makeup I'm almost like I want to wash this off my face like right now. However, this kind of look here, like I just feel so comfortable in, and I don't know, I just really like it lately. So I hope you guys enjoyed it as well. If you did, please give it a thumbs up. I will love you forever and ever. I'll still love you forever if you don't though. And I hope you guys have an amazing day. I will talk to you very soon. Bye. Oh look, the sun's coming out. Called Neon Orange. Look at this. Okay, it's not showing up as epic as it looks in real life on the camera. Love it. Oh my goodness, kind of looks like that orangey, is it My Beautiful Rocket? I think it's My Beautiful Rocket by Lime Crime. It kind of looks like that, but in a look.